Sorry about that, but I thought it would be appropriate to start with a warning that comes from Nikon. If you're not confident that you can perform the updates successfully, the update can be performed by a Nikon service representative. And the camera may be damaged if power is interrupted or camera controls are operated during the update. Do not turn off the camera, remove or disconnect the power source, or operate camera controls during the update. If the update is not completed successfully and the camera becomes inoperable, you need to take it to a Nikon representative. So what's the point in upgrading your firmware version? Well, the firmware basically controls the most fundamental things that takes place in your camera body. And that goes actually both for the lens and for the camera body as such. The top number here, the 102, that's your camera body. And the bottom one is your lens correction data. I know that I am on the latest version of the lens correction, so here I will show you the process for updating the camera body, but it's actually exactly the same process for both in both cases. Having the latest firmware version is like having the latest version of your operating system on your smartphone. It often fixes some bugs, it may enhance or bring some new features, and in this video I will show how to do that. Okay, so those of you who have seen my previous videos know that I tend to cheat and go for documentation, and this is no different. If you write Nikon D5600 firmware update download in Google search, you will get directly to the right page here, and you can see that when I open this and find number 5600 here, that the camera or the body version is on 103 and the lens correction version is 2.017. So I have the latest lens correction software, but I do not have the latest software for my camera body. So let's see what that will give us. If I then go to the specific page, you can see I get to the D5600 page, and this is the manuals page, but I actually want to go to the firmware here. There's like there are three tab sheets here. So I go to the firmware one. And distortion control data or lens data that I had under control. So it's this one that I'm interested in, the firmware. And I can go to the download page. You can see the software is pretty recent. It's from today, it's 1st of July. So this is actually only some 20 days old. Here you can choose between Windows and Mac. And what will I then get if I go from 102 to 103? Well, it's not a life-changing experience. It tells me that I will get some time zone displays that has been corrected. It's a really minor thing. But if you're on 1.00 or 1.01, you get some improvements related to the SnapBridge application and the way it connects. Makes the connection between your smartphone and the camera, and this could be really useful. So I think that if especially if you're on 1.00 or 1.01, there is some real benefit here for you to harvest by upgrading your firmware. So let's go ahead. I showed you the firmware version previously on a picture here, but just so you can see, you need to go to the setup menu, and you there can actually check the firmware version, and there's one from your lens and there's one for your body, and yeah, that's basically it. And you can see, as I was on 102 and this latest is on 103, there is an update waiting for me. If I then go to the process here, they tell me that I need to create a new folder on my computer. I need to download the relevant software, run the extraction of the software, take whatever the software produces as an output file, this is the bin file here, and move that to the root of my memory card, and then set the memory card in the camera. There should be a new menu option available there, and I should simply select that and say yes, please do the update. It will then run the update, and then I have to switch off the camera and switch it on again to see if it is there. So let's go ahead and do all this. It sounds like a lot, it's actually super easy. So what I start by doing is to actually download the software, and you can see down here, I have, as you can see, I have practiced a little bit in the making of this video. So this is, as you can see, the third time I do this, but nonetheless, show in folder. It runs this little, downloads this little, I think it's a zip file. So you need to create a folder dedicated for this one, move it over here, double click this file to run the software. It will create a folder, and in that folder you have your bin software. And then, I won't show you that, but then you simply have to insert your memory card in your computer and then drag this file to the top level of your memory card, the root level.
Here we are. The memory card is now loaded with the software in the at the root level. I insert that, close, and switch on the camera. And if you go to the setup menu, you can see that I'm here ready to see the firmware version. And if I open that, pressing OK, you can see I'm at 102. And down in the bottom there's a little bit of news because there's an update option. And this is because the camera can see that there is a piece of software in the root ready to be run. So let's give the update a try. Oh no, this is what happens in real life. But actually, I'm out of battery, so I have to update the battery. So let's fix that. Well, we try again. And select firmware version. And I'm just showing you here that you can scroll all the way through, down through this menu to the very bottom if you want to see all four pages. You can also just go one up, which will take you to the bottom, which is where the firmware version is. Let's do the update. We're ready now. Remember, it's 102. And here you see the camera body. Update from 102 to 103. And I select yes, so that has to be colored. And say OK. And now it's updating. And it may take a few minutes, but using a little bit of editing, I have managed to get this process to run a whole lot faster than it really did. I really do think it took a few minutes, but of course it's just, you know, lean back and wait for the software to do the update. And as soon as the bar is filled there, we're good to go. Camera update completed. We can turn the camera off, and now we can go check to see if the camera has the updated firmware. And hooray, 103 is now there. It still says update in the bottom. That's because I haven't removed the update software. Please like if you found this useful. Suggestions for improvements are always welcome. Thank you for watching. Take care.